Welcome back to the Arkansas A&M Black Bears Dynasty on NCAA Football 14. Guys, we have made it to our first bye week, and our boys aren't looking too bad. 1-1 on the season, coming off a blowout loss to Stanford. But this team has a lot that they can hang their hat on, man. We got our first win of the season against our rival, the Arkansas Razorbacks. And we have a lot to look forward to for the rest of the season. Let's take a look at the season stats so far through two games. As most of you guys know, Randy Thomas II has gotten the start the past two games. 22 of 38, 307, two touchdowns with two interceptions. But last week, we got our first look at Todd Robertson. And I'm not going to lie, I was very impressed at what he can do, how he throws the ball. He finished 12 of 20 for 162, but he did throw two interceptions. Moving forward, it's going to be interesting to see how Coach Thomas uses both of these quarterbacks. I feel like Todd's arm strength is elite. It's going to be hard for him to sit on the bench this season. Now, you already know Randy is probably the most spectacular football player in the Sun Belt when it comes to quarterback play outside the pocket. He could tuck it and run. He could throw the deep ball if need be. He can lead this team to a bowl game. I really do believe that. And I think the coaching staff believes that too. But does Robertson give them the best chance to go further down the road? On the ground, Randy's leading the team in rushing. 16 carries for 123 yards. He's got two touchdowns. But keep your eye on Corey Gonzalez, the true freshman from California. 13 carries, 73 yards, and a touchdown. Somebody in the comments section asked me if Gonzalez is going to be the workhorse. I believe so, man. I think that he can carry the load for this team. He's got the intangibles. He's got the traits. He can find the holes. He doesn't have quite the breakaway speed that like a Jonathan Keyes has, but he does a great job cutting into the hole, dropping the shoulders, getting those extra yards, man. And to think, this kid is only a freshman. Talking about Jonathan Keyes, he's got 10 carries for 43 yards on the season. I see Keyes as more of our third down back. He can come in and run the option play with Randy because of his speed. I do want to get him some more touches this season. But third down is where this kid's going to shine. You'll see in the receptions here in a second. Short yardage, Justin Smith is going to eat this year, man. The junior has 7 carries for 34 yards and 2 touchdowns. Again, he is our 5 yards and in, or if we need a short yard gain, Justin is our guy. Even though he's 6'1", 185, he plays bigger than that. Again, I'm interested to see how this is going to work for the rest of the year. Carrying three running backs is not something that I normally do for a team, but I think all three of these guys bring something special to our backfield. Now, Mark Lawson is a guy that I want to get the ball more to. I feel like his skill set is being underutilized. We've got to get him in more packages. So look for him to get a lot more playing time as the season goes on. Out wide, David Jones, the sophomore tight end, leads the team with 9 catches for 130 yards. We have been excited for DJ for a couple years now. When he decided to transfer in, we knew we were going to have something special. And this last week's game against Stanford, he kind of showed what he can do. I think he's going to be our leading receiver for the rest of the year, which means it takes away balls from this guy, Keith Miller. I really want him to be a Biletnikoff Award finalist this year. 7 catches for 90 yards. It's been tough getting him the ball. You can see that corners and defenses are starting to key in on Keith. But I think with his route running and his catching ability, he'll be okay. I think it's just, you know, the first two games, we played some tough teams with some tough secondaries. But as we get into Sun Belt play, I think he's going to start to shine. And as I mentioned before, Jonathan Keyes out of the backfield. This kid, man, he is something special. 6 catches, 59 yards, 2 touchdowns. None more exciting than what he did to Arkansas, breaking 3 guys' ankles on the field, man. I think Jay Keyes is going to be like that Reggie Bush type player for us. Explosive in open field, fast, juke moves. Again, I want to get him the ball more too, especially as a running back. But as a receiver, it's pretty solid. Fan favorite, sophomore wideout, Marcus Brock, 6 catches for 90 yards. Then you got Vic Johnson with 3 catches for 67. AJ Thompson, we got to get him going too, man. 2 catches for 12 yards. Ty Hill, he's got 1 catch for 21 yards. These guys, these four right here, they're great pieces for our offense. But, you know, I would love to see Brock get a few more catches. And, of course, Vic. But it's just so hard when you've got DJ and Keith Miller up here who are just elite players. To the defensive side of the ball, and look at this, man. Our captain, Rob Thomas, leading the team with 17 tackles. Rob is doing a great job this year. He has missed a couple of tackles, been out of place in a couple of plays. But I think, you know, the second team All-American, he's showing why he's the leader of this defense. They did have a tough go against Stanford last week. But again, as we get into Sun Belt play, I'm looking for him to step up big time. I legit think we found a star in Nate Johnson from Ohio, man. The true freshman has 11 tackles on the season. Last week versus Stanford, I think he had 9 tackles or 10 tackles, something like that. This kid can play all over the field. I'm concerned about him in coverage. We might look to bring him down in the box more. To be like that fourth linebacker in our base defense. But this kid, man, he can get after it for sure. Ken Anderson, third on the team with tackles. He's got 9. He got trucked last week, and I felt so bad for dude. We got Mike Davis at corner with 8 tackles. James Ryan, 6 tackles on the season. Glad to see him getting some playing time this year. Mark Prince has 6, and then Tyson Kidd has 4 tackles. So solid up top, man. A lot of our secondary guys are up here in tackles, but good to see our 3 linebackers in the top 10 for tackles on the squad. I am concerned, though. I'm not going to lie to you guys. We have 0 sacks on the season. We've played 2 teams that have had great offensive lines. So I'm interested to see as we get into Sun Belt play how our defensive line is going to play. We haven't seen anybody bring any true pressure. David Hunt hasn't got going yet. He's only got 2 tackles on the season, 1 TFL. You know, Dante Bryant, I'm looking for him to do something. And the freshman too, Charles Parks, I'm looking at him at defensive end. You know, we brought you in here for pass rush and you haven't done anything yet, man. So hopefully in Sun Belt play, these guys can get going and we can actually get after the quarterback. Same in the turnover department. No interceptions on the season. Our secondary hasn't played too bad, but at the same time, we've had chances to get interceptions. We've had 2 deflections, one by Nate and one by Ken Davis, the 2 true freshmen. But I think, again, you know, going up against 2 quarterbacks that are 90 plus, it's hard to get interceptions. So looking into Sun Belt when we have like lesser competition than what we had the first 2 weeks, I think we should be able to force more turnovers, fumbles, and definitely get some interceptions. All right, taking a look at the standings in the Sun Belt right now. Troy is 1-0 in conference and sitting at the top of the division. Georgia State, who we play next, they're 1-1, 1-0 inside the conference. South Alabama, 1-0. Idaho is 1-0. Arkansas State, they're 1-0, coming off a tough win. And then there's us, 1-1 on the season. Lafayette is 1-1. Texas State, 0-1. New Mexico State, 0-2. And then ULM, they're 0-1. Who did they play? Dang, they lost 49-0? Clemson. Yep. Okay. That'll happen every time. But honestly, man, I think we can make some noise this year in the Sun Belt. You know, A-State, South Alabama, they're like the superior teams in the conference. But there's no reason why we can't finish 3rd or 4th this year and really try to push to get a bowl game. To the recruiting trail we go. Shout out to my brother, KE Gaming. He is our new lead scout, and he's going to introduce you to the class of season 3.
Thank you all for having me. I am your recruiting host today, KE. And before I get started, I just want to give a major shout out to Big C. This is going to be a big year for our Bears on the recruiting trail. Before we look at the players, let's take a look at our pipeline states. Right now, we're doing a great job going into states like Texas, Louisiana, and Florida, and we're finding some really great players. But we have to get better recruiting at home. We only have 4 players from Arkansas. 4! There are a few prospects on the board that I believe we can get to stay at home, but let's start at the top of the board. And I think I may have found the best player in the class. I know that's saying a lot. But let me introduce you to Kyle Butler from Fernley, Nevada. Right now, he is ranked as the 51st defensive end in the country, but his tape is amazing. He is 6'5", 264 pounds. He ran an unofficial 4.52. This kid is a pure pass rusher. He has all the technique. He can swim, bull rush, use his speed to bend the corner. He is special. We're behind some big name schools, but KB is showing a lot of interest in our Bears. We need more help on that D-line. We have zero sacks through the first two games, but this next guy can change that for us. This is Corey Mark from Oklahoma, a four-star prospect and a man. 6'5", 247 pounds, not the fastest, but he has the intangibles to be the best defensive end this school has ever seen. I would compare him to Brandon Graham from the Eagles. This kid is the total package, strong, powerful, great hands to get off blocks, and when he hits the quarterback, oh, he's gonna feel it. I did reach out with some school info, and he seems very interested. I will keep you posted on this decision. I came home to Arkansas last week and got a call from Coach Lance Johnson down in Nashville, Arkansas. He thought it would be a great idea for me to come down and check out his star free safety, Sean Brown. And I'm glad he called. This kid is a ball hawk. 6 foot flat, 184 pounds, a legit four-star prospect. He's fast, not afraid to come down and make a tackle, plus has great ball skills. Now I know we have Ken Anderson right now playing free, but Sean could be a day one starter for our defense. That's how good he is. Now he wants to stay close to home. I think we can work our way up his board. Okay, here's where things get interesting. At the end of next season, we'll be losing all but two wide receivers to graduation. I have been searching across the country and came across Art Brown from Alabama, another four-star prospect. He is 5'11", 190 pounds, and he is good. Not the fastest, but has great hands, and he's a pure route runner. I would compare him to T.Y. Hilton. Not the fastest, but will route you up and make the tough grabs. We have an uphill climb with a group of Power 5 schools ahead of us, but I think we can get him. Adding depth to the offensive line is important for us. Right now, we have two solid left tackles, but Curtis Maynard could be next in line. He is a big boy, 6'4", 336 pounds from Alabama, and he is a mauler. Great strength, a solid pass blocker, and decent in the run game. I believe he will be an All-American in 2 years. The best part about this kid, a 4.0 GPA. He's looking to major in, get this, farming and agriculture. He says when he's done with football, he wants to return to Alabama and run the family farm. But before I get out of here, last season, Craig Washington was an unranked QB from Conway. This year, which is his junior season, C-Dub is starting to creep up boards. The dual threat quarterback is a two-star prospect now. I caught one of his most recent games against Jonesboro High. Washington threw for 376 passing yards and 3 touchdowns and rushed for another. He has expressed he wants to put the state of Arkansas on the map. We need to stay in his ear. I'll be back soon with an update on recruiting. But in the meantime, focus up, because Georgia State is no joke. We'll talk soon, bro. Catch you later.
KE, we appreciate you, my man. Look for KE to be here a lot more, man, giving updates on the players and the recruiting class for this year and classes in the future. We pick up things looking at the offensive line. As he said, Coach is looking to build up in the trenches, and he went up to Wisconsin and found this kid. This is Arthur Livingston from Oshkosh, Wisconsin. And you know Wisconsin, man, they are good for two things: offensive linemen and cheese. This kid is 6'6", 320. He's the number 18th ranked tackle in this class, and he is a monster. 83 strength, 77 pass block, 83 run block, and 77 impact block. We're trying to build up this offensive line, man. We want to make sure we have depth at each position on the offensive line. We've got a few tackles on the board, but again, we are trying to build up that depth moving forward. We're trying to build up that wide receiving group, man. We have a lot of juniors this year. So that means next year they'll be seniors getting ready to graduate. This is Fred Foreman from Maryland, 6'3", 208. Solid guy here, man. 90 speed. Not going to kill you with the change of direction. He's got 80 acceleration, but the hands, man, 75 catching, 77 route running. Spec catch needs some work. The release needs some work, but I'm a fan of this kid. 86 jumping. The carrying is solid. The ball carrier vision is solid. He is your prototypical possession receiver, and I think we can use a guy like that. Coach is looking to build up that linebacking group too, man. This is Matt Maxwell from Louisiana, 6'6", 236, a three-star prospect. He is very interested in coming to Arkansas A&M, and we're very interested in him, man. 83 speed, 65 agility, 80 acceleration, 75 tackle, 77 block shed. He's your prototypical tackling outside linebacker. He wouldn't play all three downs, probably your first two downs in the base defense, because his zone coverage is not that great. But again, just adding more depth to that linebacking room. At corner, we like this kid right here, Matt Scott, 6'2", 186 from Kentucky, a three-star prospect. And he's got some solid traits, 91 speed, 87 agility, 88 acceleration, 83 jumping, decent play rec, 76 man coverage, 78 zone, 80 press. Again, our corners are very important. I feel like we've got three solid ones right now. The younger guys, the freshmen like Davis and I forgot the other guy's name. They're works in progress. They're going to get better each year. I think Matt Scott could come in and be a vital part of that room. Might redshirt him if he decides to come in, because I just don't see how he'll play for his freshman year. But if he comes back his redshirt freshman year, he definitely will get a lot of playing time. Same could be said about this kid, Bill Jennings from New Jersey, 5'10", 168. And you see, we're behind a lot of big-name schools, Michigan, Nebraska, Ohio State, Clemson. They're all looking at him as well. And you can see why here. This kid is he's very good. 93 speed, 86 agility, 83 acceleration. He's not going to come down and wow you with the tackling. But look at the coverage, man. 80 zone, 76 man. Because of his size, his press isn't too good. But, yo, we put him in the slot or in a couple years, allow him to play outside. This kid could be something special for us. Like we mentioned before, we are trying to build up that pipeline state for Arkansas. Recruiting at home is very important to us. That's why we are looking at the JUCO level as well. This is Mike Blair from BB, Arkansas, 5'11", 192, a two-star prospect. Not bad traits. He's not going to kill you with the change of direction or, you know, his speed, 87 speed, 75 acceleration. But I think where he shines is in the route running and the spec catch. He's got decent hands. I'm thinking if he does decide to come to A&M, we will put the red shirt on him, allow him to build and grow in the offense, sit out a year. And I think coming back into his red shirt junior year, he'll be a solid player for us. And to round out the board, we've got two depth DNs here from Arkansas. This is Eric Carter from Morrilton, 6'2", 245. Not bad, you know, 70 speed, 78 strength, 77 acceleration. The power moves out of 76. Finesse move is a 71. Block sheds a 72. Decent tackle, great hit power. You know, I'm trying to build up the defensive line where we can have rotational pieces. You know, the two guys at the top of the board, those are our must gets. And I think if you tag team them with these two guys on the bottom, we're going to be pretty solid, man. And already the guys that we have on campus are pretty good too. And this is Robert Brooks, 6'4", 245 from Cabot, Arkansas, three-star prospect. And again, it's just more about the depth, man. He could actually play inside or out. 65 speed, 55 agility, 79 acceleration. The power moves at a 75, finesse is at a 73, block sheds a 77, the tackles a 75, hit powers a 75. You know, again, these guys are close to home. They are going to be solid players for us, just adding more depth on a defensive line that I think that is a lot better than what they were last season. But again, I think the guys at the top, Kyle Butler, Corey March, Sean Brown, Art Brown, Brian Charles, Curtis Maynard, Corey Jean, you could throw Keith Smith, Arthur Livingston. Those guys, man, these guys are going to change the culture. This will make, if we are able to get majority of these players, this class is going to be elite. And going into season 4, bro, we're going to really make some noise, especially on that defensive line. And as you can tell, coach is really focused on building up the defense. That is going to be our main focus. He feels that the offense is in a good spot right now with solid quarterback play, a great running back room. We got to add a little bit more depth at wide receiver, but the defense and the offensive line are going to be our main focus in this recruiting class. Comments down below. Let me know who's your favorite recruit that you saw today. We are going to have weekly updates on recruiting, so get ready for that, man. I'm excited to bring you guys more content. We're going to launch a Bears Den podcast next week, so get ready for that. So that's going to wrap it up for the bye week and our first look at the recruiting board. It's time to get ready for our first Sun Belt game of the year, getting ready to take on Georgia State. They've been beating us the past two seasons, but I think this year is going to be a lot different. I'm excited for it. I hope you guys are too. If you enjoyed the video, man, make sure you smash that thumbs up button. Subscribe if you're brand new. Don't forget to ring that bell. Join the Noti Squad. And make sure you guys check out those links down in my description. Follow your boy on Facebook, Twitter, and IG. And we'll talk from the Sun Belt opener versus Georgia State. Have a great day, guys. Two fingers in the air. Peace.